Chinese President Xi Jinping says Beijing and Moscow have found a secret formula for neighboring powers like them to get along with each other. Xi said these include non-alliance, non-confrontation, and not targeting any third party. The Chinese leader made that remark in a meeting with his Russian counterpart Vladimir Putin in the Russian city of Kazan, which is hosting the 16th BRICS summit. She also told Putin that amid the international situation gripped by chaos, their strategic alliance would be a force of stability. Speaking of alliances now, President Xi called on Laos to forge a model for the Belt and Road cooperation with China. Laotian President Thonglun Sisulith, for his part, said he looks forward to working with China to continuously advance the Lao-China Railway and the Lao-China Economic Corridor. The Philippine finance chief leads G24 nations in calling for stronger global financial support. Secretary Ralph Recto led Tuesday's U.S. time high-level talks between G24 finance ministers and central bankers. The group of 24 nations had proposed key reforms, including a new liquidity provision mechanism for the IMF and more concessional financing. Mr. Recto, in a briefing, called for better development cooperation and innovative solutions to pressing issues. He warned a slowdown in the global economy would hit developing countries like the Philippines the hardest. In politics, Recto says the Philippines will leverage on its close ties, including on security, with the U.S. to maximize potential impact of yet another Trump presidency. He also expects more investments from the U.S. to come into Manila, citing stronger partnerships between the two allies. Look now at foreign corporate stories. Starbucks suspends its forecast through the next fiscal year. That's as new CEO Brian Nickel looks to turn around the coffee giant, struggling with falling demand for its pricey drinks. Now, the coffee chain also reported a decline in its same-store sales, net revenue and profit, weighed down by weak demand in the U.S. Baristas are also complaining about chronic understaffing and poor pay and benefits. And finally, Meta Platforms defeat a shareholder lawsuit over child safety claims. A judge dismissed the lawsuit that accused Meta and CEO Mark Zuckerberg of misleading shareholders in a statement to ensure child safety on Meta Platforms. The judge said the plaintiff failed to show that shareholders suffered economic losses from Meta's alleged inadequate disclosures. In local corporate headlines, a major leadership shakeup at Globe Telecom. It announced the appointment of a new deputy CEO, Carl Raymond Cruz, who will take on the role on January 1, 2025, before he's nominated to president and CEO of Globe Telecom at the annual stockholders' meeting in April, eventually replacing Ernest Ku, who will continue to hold chairmanship for 917 Ventures and Globe FinTech Innovations Incorporated, or Mint, which is the holding company of GCash, Kickstart Ventures, and STT GDC Philippines. The 54-year-old Cruz is currently the CEO and managing director of Airtel Nigeria, one of the largest telco firms in Africa. Meanwhile, Price Corporation sees its net income jumping 40% in the first 9 months of the year as consolidated revenues rose 7% to 15 billion pesos. The property holding and real estate development company attributes the rise in revenue mainly to its LPG segment, which contributed 14 billion pesos. And finally, SM Prime expands its footprint in the Visayas, opening its eighth mall in the region. The four-level SM City J Mall is located in Mandaue City in Metro Cebu. SM Prime says it has already pre-leased approximately 80% of its gross leasable area. This brings the property giant's mall count in the country to 87%.